Hey, good afternoon. Thank you all for being here. My name is Abby Leonard. I'm the first vice president of the FCCJ. And we are very pleased to have our speaker today, Mr. Kaku Imamura, who's an attorney at the Junpo Law Office in Tokyo. He has a reputation for defending clients, and he has secured 15 acquittals, which is a very high number here in Japan. And he's here today to call for an end to Japan's so-called hostage justice system. And he's asking the international community for help. And this obviously comes at a time when there's a lot of attention on this issue because of the Carlos Ghosn, his prolonged detention. So you'll find handouts. Everyone should have them today. There are two lists here. The longer one is a list of lawyers who have signed on to call for the elimination of the hostage justice system. And then this additional list, the slightly shorter one, is a list of researchers and academics who are also calling for the elimination of Japan's hostage justice system. So you see there's quite a few people, and this was all assembled just in the past couple months since March. So there's clearly a lot of support for this. So with that, I'm going to hand it over to our speaker, Mr. Imamura, who will talk for about 10 minutes, and we'll have translation throughout, and then afterwards we'll open it up for questions. Mr. Imamura, thank you.
Thank you very much for the introduction. So I would like to start with the press conference.
ゴーンさんの事件をきっかけに日本の刑事司法の在り方への批判が国際的に高まっております。
Mr. Ghosn's case has triggered criticism from overseas regarding the way the criminal justice system works in Japan.
多くの海外メディアが人質司法を批判しています。
Many international media outlets criticize the hostage justice system.
こうした批判に対して、東京地方の地方検察庁の次席検事は他国の制度が自国と違うからといって簡単に批判するのはいかがなものかと反論しています。
To such criticism, the Deputy Chief Public Prosecutor of the Tokyo District Public Prosecutor's Office rebutted, saying, I'm not sure if it is appropriate to casually criticize other countries' systems just because they are different from your own countries.
しかしそうした意見は日本の法律家の一部のものにすぎません。
However, such an opinion is only shared among just one part of the legal professions in Japan.
私たち日本の法律家の多くはかねてより人質司法を批判してきました。
We as legal professionals in Japan have been criticizing the hostage justice system for a long time.
国連でも日本の刑事司法における身体拘束のあり方や代用監獄問題は以前から批判されてきました。
The way detention is used in the Japanese criminal justice system and the substitute prison issue have been subject to criticism at the United Nations from before.
しかし海外メディアにおいて現在ほど日本の人質司法への批判が高まったことはないと思います。
However, the intensity of criticism from international media outlets regarding Japan's hostage justice system has never been this high before.
この機会に多くの日本の法律家が人質司法の現状を問題視していることを国際社会にアピールし、日本の刑事司法制度改革につなげたいと考えました。
Taking this as an opportunity, we wanted to let the international community know that many Japanese legal professionals view the current status of the hostage justice system as problematic.
人質司法からの脱却を求める法律家の声明には、4月8日現在で1010名の弁護士、研究者の賛同が得られました。
So we are hoping that it will lead to the reform of the Japanese criminal justice system. As of April 8, 1,010 lawyers and researchers endorsed the statement entitled A Call to End Japan's Hostage Justice System by Japanese Legal Professionals.
以下声明の趣旨を簡単に申し上げます。
I would like to briefly go over the gist of the statement now.
日本では、起訴前において逮捕拘留日数は最大23日間あります。
In Japan, the Code of Criminal Procedure allows suspects to be detained for up to 23 days before indictment.
一つの非事実ごとに令状が発布されますので、 例えば4つの非事実で逮捕拘留を繰り返されればそれだけで92日間逮捕拘留されることとなります。
One warrant will be issued per alleged fact of a crime. So for instance, if you are arrested and detained repeatedly with four alleged facts of crimes, that alone means you can be detained for 92 days.
事件を否認していれば多くは最大限度の身体拘束がされます。
If you deny your guilt,You are most likely to be detained for the maximum period of time.
拘留場所として多くの場合警察の留置場が使用されます。
You would be detained in most cases in cells located inside police stations.
そこでは食事や排便を含め起居動作のすべてが警察の監視下に置かれます。
Your daily routine activities, including eating meals and going to the toilet, would be placed under constant police surveillance.
日本では、身体を拘束された被疑者に対して取り調べ受任義務があるとされています。
The authorities in Japan interpret the Code of Criminal Procedure to mean that detained suspects are obliged to face interrogations.
連日長時間にわたる取り調べが行われ被疑者はこれに応じなければなりません。
Day after day, suspects must go through long hours of interrogation.
取り調べ中捜査官は決して被疑者の言い分に耳を傾けようとはしません。
During the interrogation, investigators would never listen to what the suspect has to say.
被疑者はまるで岩に向かって喋っているようだという無力感に襲われるのです。
The suspect is overcome with a sense of powerlessness, feeling as if he or she is talking to a bed of rock.
被疑者が黙秘権を行使しても取り調べは続行され、被疑者は取り調べ室の椅子に座り、捜査官から質問を受け続けなければなりません。
The suspect would have to remain seated in a chair in the interrogation room, and the questioning continues.
時に捜査官に耳元で、罵声を浴びせ続けられたりします。
It is not uncommon for investigators to constantly shout abuse into a suspect's ear.
否認していると接見禁止の処分がされます。
If you deny your guilt, a prohibition of communication order would be issued by court.
そうなると家族などとの面会はおろか手紙のやり取りすら禁じられます。
Once such an order is issued, you are not allowed to meet, call, or even write letters to anyone, including your family members.
弁護人だけが接見し、通信ができます。
You are only allowed to meet and communicate with your lawyers.
しかし日本では取り調べに弁護人が立ち会う権利はないのです。
However, you're not allowed to have lawyers present during questioning in Japan.
日本では起訴前の保釈の制度もありません。
Detainees are not allowed to request bail while in pre-indictment detention in Japan.
このような長期間の身体拘束と連日の長時間にわたる取り調べによって虚偽の自白に陥る被疑者は少なくありません。
Quite a few suspects end up making false confessions as a result of a long period of detention and long hours of interrogations that take place day after day.
そしてその虚偽の自白調書によって誤った有罪判決を受けることが多くあります。
Oftentimes, such statements of false confessions would lead to wrongful conviction.
起訴後起訴内容を認めていれば早期に保釈されますが、否認している場合なかなか保釈がされません。
After indictment, if you admit the charges made, then you will be released on bail soon. But if you deny the charges, you will not be released on bail easily.
声明で挙げた例では無実の厚生労働省の局長が虚偽公文書作成罪等に問われた村木事件で合計166日間の身体拘束がされました。
In an example cited in the statement, the Muraki case, the innocent director general of the Ministry of Health, Labor and Welfare, who was indicted on suspicion of the crime of falsification of public documents and others, was detained for a total of 166 days.
13名の無実の被告人が、公職選挙法違反の罪に問われた渋谷事件では、虚偽の自白をしている人はすぐに釈放保釈され、否認している人は保釈されず、最大で合計395日間の身体拘束がされました。
In another example, the Shibushi case, 13 innocent defendants were indicted on suspicion of Public Officers Election Act violations. Among the defendants, those that falsely confessed were released on bail swiftly, whereas those that denied charges were not. One defendant was detained for a total of 395 days, which was the longest period among all.
いずれのケースも比較的軽微な罪であって、裁判では仮に有罪となっても執行猶予付きの判決か、もしくは罰金刑が見込まれる事件でした。
Both cases involved relatively minor crimes, and even if the defendants have been convicted, the sentences were expected to have been either suspended or would have resulted in a fine.
これらは特に身体拘束が長かった事件ではありません。
These are not the cases where periods of detention were particularly long.
多くの事件が否認している以上、年単位で一審判決前に身体拘束をされています。
In many other cases, because defendants deny the charges, they are detained for years before judgment of first instance is rendered.
自白すれば釈放するけれども、否認する以上釈放しないという扱いを人質司法と呼んでいます。
The practice of releasing the defendants on bail if they confess, but not the defendants that don't, is referred to as the hostage justice system.
日本で起訴された事件の有罪率は約 99.9% です。
In Japan, the conviction rate of the cases that were indicted is about 99.9%.
これは検察が確実に有罪が見込まれる事件に限って絞って起訴しているからだという面もあります。
Part of the reason is that prosecutors are only indicting the cases that they are convinced will result in conviction.
しかしこうした通知は日本の刑事裁判官に検察官が起訴している以上有罪であるとの予断を生みます。
However, such a number would create prejudgment on the part of criminal court judges in Japan.
裁判官が無罪判決を出すことに極度に慎重となる傾向を生んでいます。
So they tend to think that the defendant must be guilty because the prosecutors indicted them. This also leads to the trend where judges have extremely cautious attitude towards acquitting defendants.
疑わしきは被告人の利益にという刑事裁判の鉄則が守られていません。
The ironclad rule of criminal trial of giving the benefit of the doubt to the defendant is not being followed.
往々にして被告人が無罪を証明しなければ無罪判決が出ない状況となっています。
Oftentimes the situation is such that a not guilty judgment will not be rendered unless the defendants prove their innocence.
無実の者は当然否認します。
If you are innocent, of course you would deny charges.
しかし否認している以上身体拘束は続き、裁判の結果も無罪判決を受けることが非常に難しいのです。
However, as long as you deny charges, you will continue to be detained. It is extremely difficult to be acquitted in the end in terms of the outcome of the trial.
しかも有罪になった場合の量刑は認めた場合より明らかに重くなります。
Furthermore, if convicted, your sentence is noticeably harsher compared to a case where you admitted to your guilt.
これでは無実であっても否認を貫くことは非常に難しくなります。
So it would be quite difficult to maintain innocence, even if you are actually factually innocent.
裁判への出頭を確保するだけの目的しかないはずの身体拘束が、長時間の取り調べを受忍させる手段となり、その他の多くの負担や不利益を含めて、まるで自白を得る手段としての拷問のように使われています。
detention whose purpose should only be to secure a suspect's appearance in court has become a means to oblige suspects to accept long hours of interrogation. Including many other burdens and disadvantages, detention is used as torture almost to get confessions out of suspects.
これでは公正な裁判を受ける権利を保障されているとは言い難いのです。
Under these circumstances, it would be difficult to say that our right to fair trial is guaranteed.
この実態は日本国憲法や国際人権規約に反していると言わざるを得ません。
We would have to say that this reality constitutes violations of the Constitution of Japan and the International Covenant on Human Rights.
私たち日本の法律家は日本の刑事司法制度がかかる不公正な人質司法から脱却することを強く求め、この声明を出しました。
We, the Japanese legal professionals, issued this statement, strongly calling to eliminate such an unfair hostage justice system from the Japanese criminal justice system.
以上であります。
That's all.
Okay, thank you very much. So I would like to open the floor to questions now. So we'll start with the working press and then anyone else who has questions after that. So does anyone on this side from these tables have a question? Let's go to this in front first, yeah. And could you tell us your name and where you're from first? Thank you. Yes, please.
I'm Yuri Kageyama with AP. Are you in contact with Carlos Ghosn's lawyers, and are you working with him? And
Kageyama Yuri と申します。AP の者です。カルロス・ゴーンさんの弁護人とは連絡は取ってらっしゃるでしょうか。また彼と一緒に仕事はなさってるんでしょうか。
And also, even if you're not, what would you do to win his acquittal?
もしそうでないとしても彼の無罪を勝ち取るためにはどのようなことをなさると思うでしょうか。
私はゴーン氏の弁護人ではありませんし、ゴーン氏の弁護人はと特に連絡を取っているわけでもありません。
I'm not Mr. Ghosn's lawyer and I'm not in contact with his lawyer either.
呼びかけ人の中には、いや賛同人の中にはゴーン氏の弁護人も含まれておりますけれども、それは、たまたまゴーン氏の弁護人になったというだけであって、特にそれを意図して彼らを加えたわけではありません。
Mr. Ghosn's lawyer is among those that endorsed the statement.But it only happened that he ended up representing Mr. Ghosn. So we did not include him just for the sake of any particular, just for serving any particular purpose or anything.
私は弁護人でもないので、どうすれば無罪にするか、無罪となるかについて答える立場にありません。
Since I'm not Mr. Ghosn's lawyer, I'm not in a position to respond to the question of what I would do to win his acquittal.
Okay, thank you. Jimbo-san, yes.
ミディアニュースのジンボです。日本語で質問します。先ほどさんの先生からおっしゃっていただいたようなさまざまな人質司法の問題点なんですけれども、最終的には長期拘留を認める令状を出しているのは裁判所ですし、それから、明らかに自白が強要されているような場合でも、その偽証を裁判で認めるのも裁判所ですし、基本的に検察はどうしても矢面に立ちますが、裁判所がすべてそれを結局容認しているから、それがまかり通っているという面があると思うんですが、なぜ検察はなんとか有罪にしたいというのは分かるんですけど、なぜ裁判所までが検察と同じような行動原理で動くのか、裁判所と検察の関係ですね、そこのところをちょっとぜひご説明いただければと思うんですけれども。
I'm Jimbo from Video News. You talked about the issue regarding the hostage system in Japan, but in the end, ultimately, it is the court that accepts or that tolerates a long period of detention, and it is the court that finds the forced confessions admissible as evidence in a trial. Oftentimes, the prosecutors face the criticism regarding these issues, but again, these situations exist because the court tolerates this practice. Of course, the prosecutors would seek a conviction, but why is it that the court seems to have the same guiding principles for conduct just as the prosecutors would? What is the thinking behind that? So if you could talk a little bit about the relationship between courts and the prosecutors, that would be appreciated.
おっしゃる通り、最終的にはすべて裁判官が決めることです。
As you rightly pointed out, ultimately it is up to the judge to make the decision.
その、まあ、検察官のなぜ言いなりになるのか、なぜ同じあの検察官と同じ、行動を取るのか、まあ、その理由ですけれども、まあ、例えば。戦前には司法省という、まあ、役所がありまして、判事と検事は同じ司法省の、司法省が人事評価をしておりました。
So as for the reasons why the judges listen sort of blindly to what the prosecutor says and why judges act on the seemingly same basis of principle when it comes to how the judges behave. In the pre-war time, there was a Ministry of Justice under which both the judges and prosecutors were evaluated for the human resource type of evaluation or appraisal.
判事と検事とは完全に一体となっていました。
So the judges and the prosecutors were almost one and the same.
戦後においても、例えば人事面では判検人事交流という制度が残っております。
Even after the war, the system of exchanges of personnel among the judges and the prosecutors still exists to this day.
例えば裁判官が検察官になったりとか、検察官が裁判官になったりとか、いうふうに人事が入れ替わるわけです。
So for instance, a judge could become a prosecutor, and in turn, a prosecutor could become a judge.
さらに、検察庁は、全ての裁判官に対して、一人の担当検察官を当てるようにしています。
Also, the public prosecutor's office has this practice of assigning one prosecutor to one judge.
そうして彼らは、まあ、仕事をしている間ずっと同じ法廷で、まあ、何人もの被告人の事件を担当するのです。
So both judge and the prosecutor would work together in the same court as they handle many, many cases involving many defendants.
検事は裁判官室に平気で出入りしますし、我が家のように裁判官室の中で振る舞って今おります。
So the prosecutor would very casually and freely walk in and out of the room where the judges use, and they.The prosecutors behave as if they are in their own homes when they are in the judge's room.
また裁判所の記録を借り出して検察官室で読むといったことも行われています。
The prosecutor can also take the documents related to a particular case and take it to the prosecutor's office and read those documents in the prosecutor's office.
これに対して弁護人というのは一回一回毎回違うわけですね。
On the other hand, the lawyers will have to work with different judges on every case.
弁護人だけが法廷ではお客さんのようにな扱いを受けているわけです。
So in other words, the defense attorney alone would be treated as if he is a stranger or a guest in the courtroom.
判事と検事が一体である伝統は未だに続いていると言わざるを得ません。
I would have to say that the tradition of treating the judges and the prosecutors as one still continues.
Thank you. Okay, any more questions? Yes.
Thank you for your speech. River Davis from the Wall Street Journal. I have a question. In my understanding in Japan, there's no statutory attorney-client secrecy privilege, I think in Japanese, himitsu hitokuken. So I want to ask what kind of effect that has on your relationship with clients, how it affects your defense strategy, and whether or not it makes it more difficult for clients to disclose their matters to you. Thank you.
ワシントンストリートジャーナルのデイビスです。私の日本に対する理解のもとでは、日本の場合、依頼者弁護人間の秘匿特権、秘密保持特権というのは法定されていないということなんですが、このように秘密保持特権が法定されていないということは、クライアント依頼者との関係にどのような影響を及ぼすのでしょうか。またそれが弁護の戦略にどのように影響するでしょうか。そして依頼者からすると事実を弁護人に打ち明けるというのが難しくなるということはあるんでしょうか。
いや、日本でもですね、弁護人が依頼者の秘密を守るべき義務というのは当然あります。で、弁護人も依頼者のことをですね、法廷で証言する義務はありません。
In Japan as well, there is an obligation on the part of the defense attorney to keep secret what he learned from the client. And the attorneys are not obligated to testify on the client in court either.
その意味で、日本で特にですね、その弁護人の権利が、その秘密保持の権利が弱いというわけではないと私は理解しております。
So my understanding is that in Japan, the right or the privilege on the part of the defense attorney to maintain the attorney-client relationship or the privilege to keep secret the information provided by the client, I don't think that right is particularly weak in Japan.
Did you have a follow-up for that? Are you? Yeah. Okay. Okay, anyone else? Yes.
フランス展の及川と申します。今村先生のことを描いた NHK のドキュメンタリーを見て、大変感銘を受けましたし、週刊赤旗の方の4回の連載も拝読させていただきまして、大変感銘を受けました。そこで、質問なのですが、今村先生が冤罪人の問題について、弁護人になる、そのパッションというか、感情というか、それはどこから湧いてくるものでしょうか。以上
です。I'm Oikawa. I'm with France 10. I watched the NHK's documentary on you, Mr. Imamura, and I was very impressed watching that. Also, in the past, I also had the opportunity to read the four series article published in the Akahata, or the Red Flag, and I was also very much impressed reading that article. So my question is, as you deal with the cases of wrongful convictions, as a defense attorney, where do you get your passion, or what inspires you to work on these issues?
私は修習生の時に、刑事裁判の実務をよく見ておりました。
Back when I was a legal trainee, I observed closely what is done in practice when it comes to criminal trials.
その時に人質司法の実態も垣間見ましたし、判事と検事が一体である現状も垣間見ました。
And at that time, I had the opportunity to peek through the reality to find out about the hostage justice system. I also had the opportunity to look at the reality of how the judges and prosecutors act as one.
その中で流れ作業のように有罪にされていく被告人の姿をずっと見てきました。
I have also observed in that context how the defendants are found guilty as part of all the related parties going through the motion, just for the sake of going through the motion.
しかし、ベルトコンベアに運ばれるように有罪とされる人々の中に無実の人というのが含まれているわけです。
But then among those people that are processed through along the conveyor belt, as it were, some of them are actually innocent.
私はこのシステムはおかしいと思いました。
So I thought there was something wrong with the system itself.
それが私の刑事弁護に取り組む原動力です。
So that is the driving force behind why I deal with criminal cases.And become or how I act as a defense lawyer in criminal cases.
Thank you. Okay. Any other questions? Yes. Sure. Okay.
すいません、2回目になります。ビデオニュースの神保です。先生、もう一つぜひ聞きたいのはですね、特にここの特派員協会では関心を持っていることでもあるんですが、日本のメディアの問題なんですね。昨日弘中先生もメディアの、要するに検察や、今回の場合日産もちょっとその対象になりますが、リーク報道がいくらでも平気でそれがされていて、その実際にも裁判の前に、被告人が真っ黒に、世論的には真っ黒にもう塗られてしまっていると。でそれが、一つはパブリックイメージにも悪いですが、同時に証人になってくれる人が皆さん逃げると。それによってもうあいつは悪人なんだっていう話になるからということを弘中先生もおっしゃってるんですが、この冤罪あるいはこの人質司法の問題と日本のですね、このメディアが一体化という意味では裁判所と検察と、メディアも若干一体化しているように我々には見えるんですが、そのメディアの問題との関連を今村先生なんかはどうお考えになっているか、聞かせてください。
So this is Jimbo from Video News. This is my second question. This is of particular interest among the members of FCCJ. The question concerns the media in Japan. Mr. Hironaka mentioned this yesterday as well. But the media, and to some extent with this particular case, Nissan and the public prosecutors are free to be engaged inmedia coverage or can sort of instigate the leakage-based media reporting. So even before the trial starts, in the minds of public opinion, the defendant seems almost absolutely guilty. And this creates a bad public image as well, but not just that. This has the effect of the potential witnesses that from refrain from taking a stand in a trial, thinking that in their mind, those among the potential candidates for the witnesses, the defendant is already a bad person. This is something that Mr. Hironaka mentioned as well. So when it comes to wrongful convictions and the hostage justice system, not just the court and prosecutors are acting as one, but to some extent, media seem to be also acting as one, along with the courts and prosecutors. How do you view this situation?
メディアは、とにかくその情報を得たいと思っているわけですね。で、その情報を得たい、リークを受けたいと。で、特ダネを上げたい。で、できれば、特に特落ちはしたくないと。ということで、情報を持っている組織に対して、情報をもらうために、 その批判的なこと視点を失いがちだと、もともとそういう宿命を持っているのではないかと思います。
So media would always want to get information and so they would be more than willing to be on the receiving end of leaked information for the special reporting or they extremely dislike it when they miss out on the matters that require a special report or being able to report ahead of others. So they need information, they want to get information from the organizations that have information, so they tend to lack the perspective to be critical of that organization that has information.
特に日本では、まあ、消費者クラブ制度というものがあり、そこに、その中で、まあ、横並びといいますか、その他の新聞社が得ている情報を自分たちもたちが得られていないということに非常な不利益を感じているというふうに思われます。
So there's that the mechanism, and in Japan in particular, there's the press club system for justice-related matters. So in that legal press club system, they all want to be on par with the peers. In other words, they find it very disadvantageous not to be able to get the information that others in the industryhave access to.
そういう中でただその、警察や検察が流した情報をそのまま垂れ流すだけ の, もの、存在になり下がっていく危険性があるのです。
So in that context, there's a danger that media can fall into this role where they would simply report or regurgitate what was given to them by the police and the prosecutors.
ある検察幹部は、記事は書かせるものであるというふうに言っています。
Some senior officials in the police organization say that articles you would have to direct the media to write articles.
つまりマスコミを自分たちの広報誌にしようとしているわけですね。
Put another way, they want to or they are trying to.Turn the media into their own PR force.
そういう意味ではメディアの責任も重いというふうに思っています。
So in that sense, I believe the media share a heavy responsibility.
Thank you. I was wondering if you could talk about whether there were any court cases previously challenging the treatment of suspects or detainees here. I mean, in the U.S., you have such things like the Miranda case that established rights for people being arrested. Is that something that's ever happened here, and would that be effective in the same way? I know there's no precedent in the same way, but are there court cases challenging the treatment of suspects, and has anyone thought about bringing such a case?
少し興味があってお聞きするんですが、日本の場合は今までに被疑者や被告人の処遇を問題にした事件というのは過去にあったのでしょうか。アメリカなどの場合ですと、例えばミランダ事件だとかある程度確立したものがあるんですが、そういったことは日本でも起こったことがあるのか、被疑者の取り扱いというのを問題にした争点にした事件というのはあるんでしょうか。
まあ、弁護人の接見交通権については随分多くの判例があります。
There have been a lot of precedents made regarding the right to meet the client and to have communication with the client on the part of the lawyers.
弁護人がいつでも被疑者と自由に接見できるかといえば、昔はそうではありませんでした。
As to the question of whether the lawyers were always free to access or free to meet the suspect anytime, that was not the case in the past.
検察官が一般指定書というものを出し、
So the prosecutor would issue a designation of the times that would be available for the lawyers to see the suspect.
一般的に接見を禁止するということが行われていました。
And would in general ban the meeting or the communication between the lawyer and the suspect.
一般的に禁止されたものを例外的に解除する形で接見が認められていました。
So in other words, the meeting was only allowed as an exception against the general rule of ban on the communication or the meeting between the client and the suspect.
そのため、23日間のうち、15分の面会が3回しか認められなかったという事件が1980年代にありました。
So because of that, back in the 1980s, there was a case where of the 23 days of detention, the interview between the lawyer and the suspect, or there were only three meetings of 15 minutes each being allowed for the lawyer to see the suspect of the 23 days.
15分の面会が3回しか認められない中で、検察の側は毎日8時間から10時間程度の取り調べをしているわけです。
So the lawyer was only allowed to have three meetings of 15 minutes each. On the other hand, the prosecutor was interrogating the suspect every day for 8 to 10 hours.
こうした一般的な接見を禁じる一般指定という制度が違法ではないかという裁判が行われていたと言います。
So there was a court case where this practice of generally banning the meeting between the lawyer and the suspect, this practice was litigated in court, saying that this system or the practice must be illegal.
その結果として現在は一般的指定という制度は行われておりません。
So as a result of that case, there is no blanket ban on the meeting between the lawyer and the suspect.
例えばそんなことです。
So that's one example I can think of.
Thank you. yes.
すみません。フリーのですね、記者の松崎と申しますけれども、人質司法っていうのはですね、自白を強要させるだとかですね、長期間人を拘束するとかですね、いわゆるその言論の自由であるとかですね、基本的人権を侵害するようにも見えるんですが、違憲性についてはどういうふうにお考えでしょうか。それから今後ですね、具体的にこのグループでですね、どういった形でですね、この問題についてですね、取り組んでいこうというふうにお考えでしょうか。
So my name is Matsuzaki. I'm a freelancer journalist. So regarding the so-called hostage justice system, it seems to act against the basic human rights because this practice would force the suspect to confess, or the suspect is detained for a long period of time. It can also mean suppression of freedom of speech. Since this seems to be a human rights violation, what do you think of the constitutionality of this practice? Also, for the group as a whole, for the group that has made this statement, what specific actions do you have planned going forward?
まず憲法違反の問題からお答えしたいと思います。
First, I'd like to address the issue of unconstitutionality.
取り調べ受任義務を課して、事実上黙秘権を認めない制度、これは黙秘権侵害に当たると考えております。
So this system of obliging the suspect to face interrogations and not allowing the exercise of right to remain silent in practice or in substance, I believe this constitutes the violation of the Constitution.
しかも否認している以上、非常に長い期間身柄拘束されるわけですね。
Also, as long as you deny charges, you are detained for a very long period of time.
それはまあ起訴後も長く続いて1年2年と、執行猶予がつくような事案でもそれだけ長い間身柄拘束されるわけです。
And then that detention continues well after indictment. It could go on for a year or two years, even though the actual crime that they are accused of is relatively minor, which would only result in a suspended sentence.
これは、まあ、自白の強要にも当たるし、
This would tantamount to be, this would be tantamount to forcing confession.
また身柄の拘束ということ自体が自白を得るための拷問のように使われているというふうに考えます。
I also think that the long period detention is being used as a means to torture to get confession out of the out of the suspect.
当然拷問の禁止やそれから自白の強要の禁止に違反していると考えます。
So naturally, I believe that this practice is against the ban or prohibition on torture, and also this practice is against the practice of forcing the suspect or defendant to confess.
こうした扱いの下では公正な裁判を受けているとは考えられません。
So under such treatment, you cannot say that you have right to fair trial.
公正な裁判を受ける権利も侵害していると思います。
So I believe this also violates the right to fair trial as well.
それからこのグループの運動について申します。
So as for the activities of the group.
グループと申しましたが、実は全く、これは急遽作った、まあ、グループでもないわけですね。
Actually, I refer to the group of people as the group, but this is not really a group that is formed in any official way or anything.
今後の運動についてはこれから相談しますが、
As for the activities going forward, we will consult amongst each other.
少なくとも、ホームページを立ち上げたりとか、そこに人質法の事例を載せたりとか、そういったことは考えております。
But at least we are thinking of setting up a homepage or a website on the issue of the hostage justice system, and perhaps we will have aList of cases that where the this practice of hostage justice system was called into question.
以上です。
So that's all.
Okay, you've already had. Does anybody else have a question that hasn't asked a question yet? Okay. Yes.
フランス店の及川と申します。先生が痴漢冤罪の事件で、無罪まで、持ち込んだということで、痴漢冤罪のことについて、伺いたいと思います。私も知り合いが去年4月17日、まあ、痴漢をして、これは冤罪じゃなくて全部警察の言う通りにしたら、1日半で出てきて罰金刑が30万で済んだと。しかしもし否認をしてしまうと2、3ヶ月拘留されるわけですし、勝てる見込みが、まあ、0.01% でございますね。このような状況で痴漢冤罪をなくすには何が必要だとお考えでしょうか。
So, this is Oikawa from France 10. I would like to ask you about the cases of groping, since you, Mr. Imamura, was involved in a case of someone wrongfully convicted for groping and winning an acquittal on that case.An acquaintance of mine was arrested and charged for groping on April 17th. In this particular case, that was not a wrongful conviction, but he listened to everything that police had to say. He listened to what the police said, and he came out in just a day and a half, and he only had to pay a fine of 300,000 yen. But had he denied the charges, he most likely would have been detained for 2 to 3 months. And in terms of the probability of winning in the trial, it would only be 0.01%. So under such circumstances, what do you think is necessary to eliminate the wrongful convictions involving cases of groping?
痴漢冤罪の問題は人質司法問題と非常に密接に関連していると思います。
The issue of groping or molesting is very much related to the hostage justice system.
例えばですが、昔は迷惑防止条例違反の罰金、刑罰の上限が罰金5万円だった時代があります。
For instance, there was a period of time where the fine that you would be levied was up to 50,000 yen under the ordinance to prevent public nuisance.
もちろん認めれば即日釈放されます、されていました。
Of course, if you admitted, then you were released on that very day.
しかし否認すると逮捕拘留され、しかもその拘留期間が120何日に達した事例がありました。
But if you deny the charges, then you could be arrested and detained. And in one particular case, the period of detention stretched to more than 120 days.
しかも、まあ、おっしゃるように、無罪になる確率というのは非常に低いわけですね。
On top of that, as you said, the probability of your winning an acquittal is very, very low.
それならば認めて罰金刑で済まそうという考え方が出てきてもおかしくありません。
So in that case, in that case then I can understand how you might think that it's better to admit the guilt and just pay the fine and then come out.
そうなると、まあ、本来無実である人もまあ、認めて軽い刑で済まそうということになってきます。
So in that case, even if you're factually innocent, you may be tempted to admit to the crime that you did not commit and treat it as just a minor crime or admit that you have committed a minor crime.
こうした事態をなくすことは、まあ、痴漢冤罪をなくすためには、やっぱり人質司法そのものをなくさないといけないと、こういうふうに思います。
So in order to eliminate such a situation, you would have to eliminate this hostage justice system to prevent any wrongful convictions related to regarding molesting or groping.
Yes.
A clarifying question on my previous question. So how does Himitsu Kotsuken in Japan differ from attorney-client privilege? Thank you.
先ほどさせていただいた質問に関しての確認としてもう一度お聞きしたいんですが、日本における秘密保持の権利というのは他の国での依頼者弁護人間の秘匿特権とどう違うんでしょうか。
他の国、まあ、例えばその日本での実態を言いますと、まあ、あるケースで、まあ、往々にしてあるんですけれども、弁護人がに対して何を接見で何を話したか話せと言って、それを調書にまとめてた事件があります。
So to describe what happens in reality in Japan, what happens quite often is that the investigator would demand the suspect to tell the investigators what the suspect talked about during the meeting with the lawyer, and the investigator will turn that into a statement.
声明文にある渋谷事件という事件ですが、そうした調書を70通も作成しておりました。
So in the case of the Shibushi case that is mentioned in the statement, the investigators created such statements, which amounted to 70 in the end.
これは明らかな弁護権の侵害なのです。
This is clearly a right to a violation of the right to defense.
したがって、国家賠償請求訴訟が起こされ、その事件では国に賠償義務があるとされました。
So in this particular case, thereafter, there was a suit that was filed to seek the damages based on the wrong conduct on the part of the government, and in the end, the government was held liable for the damage.
諸外国のことは、まあ、よくは知らないのですけれども。
I'm not too familiar about how the practice works in how it is practiced in other countries.
ここまでひどく秘密交通権を侵害している先進国はどうでしょうか、あるんでしょうか。
But I wonder if there are any other so-called advanced countries that would violate the attorney-client privilege or the attorney-client privilege in such a a bad extent.
Thank you. So, okay, we just have time for maybe. Do you have another question? Okay, just very briefly, one more question. Thank you.
すいません、何度も。ビジネスの神保です。今回ゴンさんの事件は司法取引によって、まあ、立件されたと。で、まあ、司法取引としては去年6月に導入されてから2件目ということなんですが、まあ、この冤罪の問題や人質司法の問題に取り組んでられる先生方にとってですね、今回、まあ、人質司法の部分がほとんど、まあ、一応録音録画とか多少入りましたけども、まあ、全体の中で非常に少ないパーセンテージが入らない中で、司法取引という制度が導入されたことによって、冤罪のリスク、あるいはもともとある人質司法の問題というのにどういう影響があるか、そこのところをお願いします。
So this is Jimbo from Video News again. In the case of the in the case involving Mr. Gon, this was a result of the plea bargain system that was introduced in Japan in June of last year, and it was reported that this is the second case that utilized the plea bargain system. So to those that work on the issue of the hostage justice system and those that work on the wrongful conviction cases, when it comes to hostage justice system, there are small number of cases where the videotaping or recording was introduced. But with the introduction of the plea bargain system, how will that increase the risk of wrongful convictions, and also how will that impact the issues surrounding hostage justice system that existed from before?
ゴン氏の事件に関しては、その他の経営者の責任はどうなんだっていうことがよく報道で言われますよね。で、確かにそのいろんな情報を提供しているんですけれども、その自分たちもまあそれを知ってたからこそ情報提供できるわけで、まあ、見過ごしていた経営者の責任というのは本当はあると思うんです。ただ司法取引をしているから自分の責任は問われないと。それでまあゴーン氏らのその責任だけを追及するということになっているわけです。これが果たして公正かどうかというのは問題があることだと思います。
So in the case of the case involving Mr. Gon, it is reported in various media that that call into question the responsibility for others in the management. The case was predicated or that the case was based on the information that was provided. But the information was provided because those in the management had that information. So you could question the responsibility of those in management that looked the other way, as even if they had the knowledge of this of the wrongful or inappropriate action. So, but then since they are engaged in pre-bargaining, their own responsibility will never be called into question. And in turn, Mr. Gon and others only are being pursued. So I think it's quite problematic in terms of whether such practice is fair.
しかも、同じ共犯、いわば共犯関係にあるものの一部がその先に、捜査官に対して申告をした場合、その人の責任が先に、その申告をした人の責任は逃れて、申告をした人は責任を逃れて、申告された人は責任を問われると、これが公正かどうかということは一つの疑問だと思います。
So to put it another way, there was a relationship of conspiracy among several members, and only part of the members offered information to the authorities, and those that provided the information will be exempted from any responsibility, whereas those where the information was provided on would be called into question in terms of his or her responsibility. So that calls into question whether such way of dealing with this the issue is fair or not.
冤罪の危険性に関して申しますと、ゴーンさんの事件は、いわば共犯関係のある人同士の供述だと思うんですけれども、自分とは全く関係ない他人の罪を供述した場合も司法取引が成立するようになっています。
So, to comment on the risk or the danger of any wrongful convictions, in the case involving Mr. Gon, there was a relationship of conspiracy, or there these are, you can say that there were all co-conspirators, but in some cases you could rat on a completely unrelated parties and would still go for the plea bargaining arrangement.
全く関係ない他人の罪を明らかにすることによって、どうして自分のそれと関係のない自分の罪が軽くなるか、その理由が分かりません。
And I fail to understand the reason why your guilt should be lightened by giving information on someone else, a complete stranger, someone that has no relationship whatsoever with you.
しかもアメリカで多くあった事例ですけれども、同房者が被告人が犯行告白をするのを聞いたと嘘の供述をして、自分の罪を軽くして無実の人を冤罪に陥れている事例が多数報告されています。
Also, I hear that there are many cases in the US where someone that was put in the same cell and others would report to the investigators saying that I heard so and so say that he or she committed a crime, and by giving that false information to the authorities, the person that told the information would have the sentence be lightened while putting in an innocent man to be convicted. I heard that there are many such cases in the US.
そうしたことは拘禁施設の中で起こるのですね。
And this kind of thing would take place in the detention facilities.
身柄拘束期間が長い日本の中では、そうしたことが起こる危険性も、高いんではないかというふうに危惧しております。
And I am concerned that since in Japan the period of detention is much longer, there will be a much greater danger of someone, roping someone else into a crime that, that was not committed by that person.
Okay. Thank you. I think that's a good place to leave it. We're just a little bit over time, but thank you very much. I'm sorry I didn't get to everyone's questions. It was really interesting. There was clearly a lot of interest. So thank you very much, Mr. Imamura-san, for coming today.
ありがとうございました。